This time the quick speed shot. You've seen my fluid film video. Well, I got a new video today. I'm going to do a comparison test between the original fluid film and its competitor, Woolwax, made by Kelsport Products, and this is in black. For several years now, I've been using a fluid film. This is the original lanolin-based undercoating. It's made out of wool wax from sheep wool. And now, the company that I originally bought my gun from, Kelsport Products, I got my undercoating gun from, they have gone out on their own and they've made their own formula of lanolin-based undercoating. It's called Woolwax. You can find it at, I think, woolwaxusa.com or kelsport.com. But I just ordered a gallon and this comes in black. So I'm very excited to use this on my undercarriage, on my axles and leaf springs and stuff. I always wanted the chassis black and the wheel wells black. And fluid film would go on clear, so you'd see whatever color wheel wells or any rust on the frame or all that you'd see. So now I've got this black undercoating. I'm going to pop the sucker open. And they claim that this has a little bit thicker and hangs on longer than fluid film. And I can't speak to that either way because I haven't tried it yet, but we're going to do a couple comparison tests and see what we see and see how I like it. So let's bust these open and we'll take a look. Now here's my fluid film. I've just used some of this a little while ago on my truck. Where is it? Here it is. It comes in this clear slash butterscotch color. It's got the strong lanolin odor. Here you mix it up nice, so you can see it's consistency here on the dipstick, on this paint stir rod. It's about 52 degrees in my garage right now, so this is going to be a little bit thicker than if you're spraying it at 70 degrees. Well, we got the fluid film here, and now this is the first time I've ever opened this Woolwax in black. Let's see what this looks like. Holy cow, it's black! Look at that! It's definitely got a lower odor than the fluid film. They said they made a new low odor formula. So just so we can contaminate our comparison. Oops. Let's go ahead and look and see what this looks like. It's definitely thicker too. This gallon's been in my house, so it's about 65 degrees. But even being 15 degrees warmer out, there it is. You can see it spools out. Down there it's a little bit thicker, but it's got a nice black color. It definitely feels a little bit thicker than the fluid film. So it doesn't have the lanolin smell that fluid film does, but it's got some kind of chemical odor. I'm not really sure what it smells like old rotten socks and feet maybe. Not really sure what that odor is. It smells like a little bit of rubbery smell. It's definitely not the lanolin smell, but so there we go. We got our two products here. They're both going to be compatible with each other because they're both made out of wool wax, lanolin wax out of sheep wool. So I'm sure it'll be fine to compare them. But I've got a brand new jug. We're going to put the black in here. And here's my original fluid film gun that I got from Kelsport Products. I've been using this for several years. It's got fluid film in this. And I went out and I sprayed some on my S10 a minute ago on the frame with the regular fluid film. So let me take this off. And I'll clean the gun off a little bit. And we'll put the black on here and see what we get here. I've contaminated my fluid film with wool wax. There we go. Made a sin already. So here is my rusty S10 and here's a frame. And this is a rear wheel well. So you can see the frame is pretty scaly and nasty. First, I'm going to use the fluid film. Now it's about 38, 40 degrees out, so it's a little cold to be spraying this. But let me spray on the clear fluid film. You can see this and see how it covers. So I got a nice coating of fluid film. It's a little yellow now as it gets in the metal. It'll clear up a little bit, but you can see the consistency of how it went on, you can see the consistency of how it went on, and it's slimed over there, but when it dries clear, you're still gonna see the rust through. So this new product, Woolwax, made by Kelsport Products, I'm hoping to use the black and to coat this frame and have a black look to it. And this truck I'm not really worried about because it's the last winter for it and it's really, really rusty. I never put fluid film or anything on it before, and I wish I had about 8 years ago because it would have saved it. But I just want to use this as a comparison so you can see the fluid film versus, we'll go with the Woolwax Black and put it over here. All right, you can see where I sprayed the fluid film here a little while ago. It's starting to set in. I'm gonna hit this gun and give it a blast to clear the fluid film out of the tube. And pretty soon we should start to see the black come up here. Here we go. Let's do the black back here. All right, as you can see, the Woolwax Black has gone and made the black frame all shiny black, compared to the fluid film up here, which is right now a little bit butterscotchy, but it will clear up when it dries out. But I like how it covers up the rust on the frame and gives it that black undercoating look. Let me spray a little more in here. See, it blacked that right out, and it's got a little heavier consistency than the fluid film. We'll have to see how it does, but what I want to do is go over to my F-250, which I've already fluid filmed for the winter, and I want to put some of this black on the suspension and all that and try to black it out in the wheel wells a little bit. So let's go over there. So this over here is my F-250. As you can see by the shine below the pinstripe, I've actually sprayed fluid film about halfway down on the truck, and it's it went on yellow, but now it's in the sun, it's warmed up and it's turned to clear and it's flowed down. But I want to hit the frame and the suspension and all that with this Woolwax Black. I want to black that out in the wheel well, so let's take a closer look. I've got fluid film on here. Let me hit some Woolwax over the top of it and black it out. It's a little hard to see here, but you can see I blacked out my spring and I blacked out the frame here, made a nice coating, and it's a little bit thicker than the fluid film, so I'm hoping that it stays on here all right. Here I've used some black spray paint. I've touched up this cab corner, which is rusty, and I'm going to replace this in the spring, so I'm going to hit it with the fluid film black, or the Woolwax Black, and see what it does here. So there, I've used some Woolwax Black and I just put some black on top of the rust, and hopefully this will keep it looking good. It's going to have extra protection. And what I really want to do is go under this and hit the frame under here of this truck, but it's kind of cold out now, but I think you can see a good comparison of clear fluid film on top of, which both these products are safe to be used on paint. This has got the paint on the truck, obviously. And both products are safe to use over paint or plastic or electrical connections, but I wouldn't want to spray the black, you know, off the side of the truck because it'd be obvious. Down here I've got some just black spray paint, so it doesn't matter. But what I'm really hoping this product's gonna be good for is doing the chassis and the axles and suspension and all that, where in the wheel wells where you want that black look, and it's got a higher clingability apparently than fluid film according to the manufacturer. So I'm going to be trying this over the winter and seeing how it makes out here. I've done good with fluid film, but this Woolwax, if it works, I'm not opposed to switching over. I can tell you that the cold weather is really taking a toll on the Woolwax. It's gone down about 36 degrees. It's too cold to spray this stuff in any time of quick fashion, but I think you can see I've sprayed the frame here, and I sprayed the seam, and I sprayed the upper wheel wells where salt likes to get, and I put a good coating of black on here. It's coated the frame good, so this is giving me a good test point as I ride through the winter. I can be monitoring this real easy through the wheel well and see how the Woolwax Black is doing. If you're going to apply this, I'd say at least be 50 degrees out, because it's just, unlike the fluid film, which will spray a little bit colder weather because it's a little bit thinner, the Woolwax is too thick to spray in this cold weather effectively. But I've got a good coating on this section of frame and wheel well here for a good test on this truck. Like I said before, I've already sprayed the entire truck with fluid film about a month ago, so it's got a real good coating underneath, and I just touched up the outside of the body today with fluid film. But I wanted to put the Woolwax here on the frame in this area that I like to have blacked out so I can monitor it and see how it does here. All right, so what are my final thoughts here? I think these are both good products. The fluid film is easy for me to get. I can get in the local store. It's $42 a gallon for me, my cost, and $42 a gallon for the fluid film. I ordered the Woolwax right from Woolwax USA, I think it is. I'll put a link in the description. But I ordered this gallon in black. Now you pay a $7 premium to have the black coloring, but it was $56 for this gallon shipped to my house, free shipping. So $49 if you get. I'm sure I should also mention that you can get this Woolwax also comes in clear, just like the fluid film. So a gallon of clear Woolwax is $49. I paid the $7 premium to have it tinted black. So $56 for this, or $49 for clear versus $42 locally for fluid film. But this is definitely a thicker product. As I was trying to spray it out in the cold weather, I had to stop spraying because it just got too cold. I would have to heat the material up in the gun with like a heat gun or something like that to keep it flowing. But fluid film, you can spray a little bit colder weather. It seems to be a little bit thinner. So I'm going to be excited to see if this sticks on and lasts a little bit longer during the winter weather because it's a little bit thicker. But I like the way it coats everything. I love to have my wheel wells and my frame rails and springs painted black underneath the truck. And I've actually got my 77 Ford truck. I want to use this in the springtime and do the chassis and the suspension. I want to do this black Woolwax on that truck because it sits outside all summer in the weather, but I want to have the chassis be black under there, and I've been waiting to paint it with black Rust-Oleum and then put fluid film on it, but I think I'm going to try this product and see if I can just do it all in one shot and protect it and have the chassis be black as well. But they're both excellent products. I've sprayed a lot of fluid film. I've done, last couple of years, I've done probably 20 cars of fluid film. I've gone through 17, 18 gallons of it easily, and it always works good for me. It seems to run real nice everywhere. I can spray it everywhere. The downside is a little bit of lanolin smell that some people don't like. I actually like the smell of it, but I wanted to try the Woolwax, which has a little bit different odor. It's a little bit less odor, but it does definitely have an odor. They claim it's low odor. It's just a different odor as far as I'm concerned. It appears to be thicker. I love that it comes in black and or clear, but I love that it's available in black. And I think they're both great products. I'm going to be using a combination of both. I think what I'll do is I'll spray my chassis components in Woolwax Black, and then I'll either use their product Woolwax Clear or fluid film, because I can get it locally. I'll probably be using a combination of both. I'll keep one jug for black and then the other one for clear, and I'll be using both these products. But I just want to do a little comparison video, since I did my original video on fluid film, that there is another product out there and it's got a cool option of black. So there we go, a little comparison of fluid film versus Woolwax in black. Alright, so that's it. Thanks for watching on this cold November day, my comparison of fluid film versus Woolwax in black. So as always, thanks for watching. Please subscribe. I'm putting out new videos every Wednesday and Saturday. Hit the bell for the alerts. Tell your friends. And as always, we'll see you right back here at the Quick Speed Shop for fluid film, Woolwax, hot rod builds, rusty junk, whatever else is going on here at the Quick Speed Shop.